And we're back. There's a look at Aware. They start off so hot in that first respawn, but really cooled down after taking round one of S and D. It was strictly business who was really doing the slaying in that last game.
Yeah, specifically Twizz and FizzUp. You know, they had poor first game, picked it up massively in the second game to be backpacking the team, essentially, in the Search and Destroy.
Now, this means so much for both squads right now. Aware trying to secure the top spot in Pool D. SB fighting for the last spot in the winner's bracket. We'll find out, can they force a three-way tie and potentially win that one? They already have a loss to Aware, which is not gonna help their cause, but we'll find out if they can keep things going as we head to Detroit for some uplink. Now, Ben, when you look at these two squads, I'm thinking this is all Aware, just judging by their performance on Solar. They seem to be more aggressive and much more mobile than this SB crew.
Yeah, I agree. Even when it comes down to uplink, I feel like Aware, you know, they have a lot more tournament practice, in terms of online tournament practice at least, than Strictly Business do. Whether Strictly Business have been, you know, testing out some things online and scrimmages and whatnot, we'll have to wait and see. But for me, I think, you know, when you have a player like Sender, and especially a player like Happy, who just seems to love killing things and respawn, this is going to be very tough for Strictly Business, especially if Twizz and Fizz can't hold their own.
Gung ho for everybody. Actually, two fast hands there, and it looks like we're going to do a quick restart on the map up. But when playing on Detroit, Ben, I know you really like attacking from the school side, but do you feel this map has a whole lot of favoritism to one side or the other, or is it basically even?
I personally prefer attacking into the school side because, well, a lot of people, what we haven't seen, and this is the big thing, is when, I still feel like teams haven't figured this out properly yet. Or I feel like they know it, but when they're in the game, they haven't got good at making the right decision. Mm-hmm. If I'm playing you, for example, and I'm 2-0 up,
right,
the best thing I can possibly do is just shoot for one point. Because that immediately means you have to have the ball
two times. Second possession, right?
Right, it's a two-possession game. And then after that, I can go for the, you know, the glamorous two-point play. Or again, just maybe go for a one-point play. And that's cool, you know, it has that one little room by the window. You can just jump in there, and all you have to do is throw it. It's very simple. And the only way someone is stopping that ball going in from that room is by an interception. That's the only way.
I'm looking over at Sin there, the third from the right, and he is all smiles talking with FizzUp, getting ready to go. Let's start our first game with him because, you know, Sin was really the only player on this SB squad that put up decent numbers on Solar.
He was, and, you know, he was pretty consistent, but again, for me, we have to keep our eyes on, of course, Twizz and Fizz in that KD column. They need to be able to hold their own in this game type. And straight away, you can see Sin just going to be covering that left-hand side. Now going to jump across as three plays go down. This is a fantastic start for SB.
And right away, Sin is going to get this satellite making his way to the uplink. Going to be met with a little bit of resistance as you see Twizz leading the way. We'll see if Twizz is able to get in position for a pass. It looks like a charge at the back door. Fizzer, last man standing, is now going to have to play some D. Sender moving in with this objective.
Yeah, Sender immediately has to run backwards. He recognizes that he can't push forward by himself. He's just going to get picked off. He needs his teammates kind of, as you've been describing all weekend, which is very true, kind of like running that blocking kind of style. You know, they need to make sure that he can get through, and we saw it perfectly with Killer in Optic Nation. You know, whenever they're playing uplink, they kind of have someone blocking the way, running in front of the satellite drone carrier, making just that job so much easier.
Twizz now with the satellite is going to be making his run through the alley. Great movement so far by both squads. And you're going to see Twizz get it close, but not close enough to go for a shot. FizzUp now trying to hunt down this ball. It's going to be in the hands of Accuracy. Accuracy going right down the garage is going to have one player leading the way once again. And probably the best option here, it's Lawless at the moment. Lawless with two players attacking will not be able to get it done. It's up to Happy and Sender now on defense.
Happy needs to try and pick up this kill. Turns around, but there's going to be so many players chasing him. Didn't really stand much of a chance. However, Sender is going to clean up one. Will be one more play there. Meanwhile, the satellite drone carrier is John, and John is just booking it straight towards it. Is he going to go for the one
point?
Such a smart play. Such a smart play. He recognized that there had to be some players playing defense. He didn't want to risk the 2 points. Just went for one.
FizzUp waiting for this new ball as it's going to drop right in front of him. He's got the satellite trying to figure out how to get in. Unfortunately, there's a knife in his mouth.
Kapowie.
That one coming from Lawless. Lawless immediately taking fire. Great cover, though, from a teammate. He's going to toss it, catch it up.
I love
and
that.
Ben, why does he do this?
That's so smart. I haven't seen anyone do that so far. Now, when you're the satellite drone carrier, you know you get increased ammo. Now, as soon as you get shot a couple of times, Yarama is gonna go. Okay? Now if you just throw the ball down and pick it back up, Yarama comes back to full. So if you're tagged up and you think you're gonna go for the play, the best thing you can do is immediately drop the ball, pick it right back up. That was really good to see because I haven't seen anyone do that yet.
Heads up play. All of these kills though coming in from SB. John is gonna pick up one on a teammate, unfortunately though. Twiz in that kill feed as well. Now with the satellite, he's gonna be making his move. The ball tossed over to John. He's not gonna be able to get much done. Fizzer on your screen needs to protect his base because here comes Happy. Happy, go for the toss from your window, Ben.
There you go.
And
that's
you are
exactly
a happy
what
man.
I was talking about. Exactly again, and it's so good to see. And you saw the only way SB could try and defend against that was to try and go for the interception. And you saw two players double jump to try and catch that ball before it actually went into the portal, and they just weren't allowed to do it. It's really good to see two teams playing uplink in a really, really correct way.
Sender going for the same shot, goes for the duck.
It's easy points, man.
Nice
easy
angle.
Points.
Nate's coming in. And really, you think SB has to catch on to this. They have to start putting a player permanently in the school, and that is not what they want to do because they've been pushing all of their runs through the alleyway. So on your screen right now, we're waiting for Happy. He's got his teammate Sender behind him. Happy trying to lead this charge. Sender's just going to run in first. Won't be able to get it done.
Hello. That's going to be, is that Twiz or was that Fizz? Let me find
out. I believe it's Fizz because he's now got
yeah,
the
it is.
Satellite. Yep.
So
he's running the double. Overclock Stim. I like this combo for an objective position.
Yeah, for, you know, playing the uplink carrier, that's a really good idea. Oh, he just turns around and says, hello, melee attack to the face. Hits him with the drone. He went for the second one, but he's still alive. Now, you see, the best thing he could do here would be to throw on the floor and pick it back up, but he's going to go for an epic fail of a one-point play.
No, he was getting his armor back,
No, he wasn't. He was trying to, let's not try and give him that much props. That was definitely a fail. Unfortunate play from him, but that
Look
drone
at
is still
Sin,
there.
Man. Sin just cleared the base. No one up yet.
He has to go for one. There you go. And that was a smart play. Just level up the game. Going for two was a bit risky there, so he made the smart decision.
Twiz and Sin still up for SB. Sender, though, with the uplink, is going to push one more time. 20 seconds left on the clock. They got to be careful. He knows there's an opponent in here. Just charges
down.
In, goes for the beatdown, knows he's got enough armor to get there in time. 12 seconds left. He needs some big help. And he's going to try and cut this back into the school, I have a feeling. Unfortunately, two teammates going down, hit with stuns. Not going to be able to get much done. Nope. He's just going to keep this out of his opponent's hands.
That was a really strange play. But
well, he realized he wasn't going to score.
He could have arguably cut into school when he was at staircase and just tried to go back into that room one more time. You know, when there's, what, 10 seconds left, what are you going to lose? There's no way that someone is going to be able to Hail Mary it that far when you know they're all going to be playing hard D.
We're all tied up at the half. Switching spawns, going at it one more time. This will be the swing game in the series. We're tied up 1-1 in the best of five. First, the respawn, the hard point taken by this Aware squad. SB looking so strong in S&D, and so far, pretty even game in uplink. Ben, do you have a team? Do you think one is playing better than the other?
Right now, no. We've seen good moments from both, but you know, in my opinion, the side SB is on now is arguably stronger just because of that school side, so I expect to see them pick up a couple of easy points if they do exactly what we saw Aware do. Which, honestly, after conceding 2 points, I would expect SB are like, oh, that seems like a pretty sensible position. Let's try and throw it from there.
Accuracy on your mini-map with that objective, trying to make his way through the garage. He's got only one teammate distracting over on the alleyway, and it looks like this could be a big mistake as you see Sin immediately grabs the satellite, won't be able to push it up too far. A big kill coming in from Happy.
Sin was also using Stim there, so right now you have both Sin and Fizzer going doubles up on Stim and Overclock. So they're trying to be the objective carriers of the satellite drone. However, Sender with the drone in hand is looking at trying to put some yards down, and he could just go for the 1 point play here. That's the double jump. It's a very common throw spot, but he's actually missed it, and it's so nearly bounced in too.
He's got a rebound potentially. Accuracy trying to get in there, and the satellite is picked up by Fizz. He's immediately going to toss this one out. It'll reset in the middle of the map. There it drops, and we're going to see John pushing for it.
Oh, wow. Sender actually just got destroyed a little bit there by Sin. Meanwhile, SB are going down. Sin is trying to camp that satellite drone respawn point, but he goes down too. That leaves John up momentarily by himself, but John 17 and 17.
Big kills in the base by the teammate. Happy trying to get shots down as two more players spawn up. He's going to lose his support. He's got to wait for someone to come on that back end. I believe that was Mr. Lawless, and now he's got a one-point opportunity, tosses it to his opponent, won't be able to get it done.
If that hit his opponent, that would have been very, very impressive. I think that's what he was going for there,
right.
But got a little bit unfortunate. 3 minutes left of this second side. Sin making his way into the parking garage. Is he going to be able to try and make his way into the school as well? He is, but this is the problem. He's in front of all of his teammates. He needs to wait for his teammates to try and clear out this room, and that's exactly what he's doing. This is smart play coming in from SB.
SB pushing up. Sin won't be able to get it out. Happy's gonna fall center now, charging in, is gonna finally get this satellite out of the base. They'll be pushing it back alley once again. Look for another toss opportunity if he can get behind that tractor trailer. Already met by a player on mid street, needs help immediately. In this middle room, it's very short range, and you can see he was trying to set up that melee.
You got a little unfortunate that his melee didn't actually hit that. But you see, he got out. His nice little two-piece coming in. Nearly killed his teammate there. Who's the satellite drone carrier? It's going to be accuracy this time. 13 and 21, by the way, so not having the best of games. Is he going to go for the one-point play? Still has a satellite drone in his hand. We'll see. This will be the 1 point. No, he's not going to go for it, I don't think. Oh, there it is, actually.
Oh, intercepted!
Fizzer, that was so nasty! Oh, that was sweet.
Call this man Richard Sherman.
Oh, Fizzer
says, get this out of my house. Tosses it over the fence. It resets in the middle. And what a performance.
Oh, you know he's going to have a smile on his face after doing that. That was going in, and Fizzer just managed to get that double jump interception and gets it straight out of bounds.
Oh, John, no, the pass getting John, stuck on the wall. That was a two-point play. They had it all set up. And Sender going to reap the reward. He is going to grab this immediately. Unfortunately, won't get it very far. Twiz now picking it up. He's going to die. John and Fizz trying to push in. They got to stop this team as eight aware. They got a minute 15 still to work with, and we're still tied up 2-2. A single toss-in could be the difference maker in this game.
Yeah, 100%. We're in the last, what, 70 seconds right now? Any points realistically could win you this game. It's been so close, it's pretty much a stalemate all game, and that's why I'm surprised we saw SB go for the two-point play as opposed to just a one-point play from the window. You know, that 1 point could be potentially huge.
Sender pushing up once again, gonna find one. Fizzerp, though, with the satellite, is trying to run away, and Fizzerp is gonna get the melee kill. One more player outside, he's gonna juke through the middle, climb it through the window now, his teammates in support. Fantastic plays here with Fizzer.
Just get to that window.
Running this one, 30 seconds left, and he's gonna go for the toss.
There it is!
It's gold! Now the pressure is on Aware.
Can Aware somehow manage to set up for a one-point play, two-point play to potentially win it? Stim helping out Fizzer massively, but Sin is slaying from inside Aware's base. Look at that mini-map on the top left of your screen. There is no one there as Fizzer actually now has control of the drone. Sender desperately trying to chase him, but that's Stim being used by Fizzer. And with 7 seconds left, Puckett, that is going to be GG. Fizzer, man of the match without a shadow of a doubt in my mind. That interception came in huge and won SP that game.
It wasn't just the interception, though, Ben. After that interception, he put the moves on two players over by the school building, jumping over the fence. He got the melee coming out of the garage, going through the window, and getting the score in the final minute. A big play from SB. And now, Aware, the smiles are gone. You gotta wonder, are they getting nervous? We'll find out, can they tie things up? We have another respawn left. Where are we going next?
I'm actually not too sure what the actual map section is, even though I do have it directly in front of me.
Capture the Flag is coming up next, guys. We'll be right back.